have this done? I don't know what this was, but it was some classical music. People are going outside looking in. Maybe they wonder, what is this man doing? I'm just doing my thing. Maybe the audience in the end here is coming to look outside my living room into my my studio, and that would be quite nice. I don't oppose that in any way or form. Just go outside and try to listen to me. But this is a recording. This is not live. This should be just as it is, when it is, like that. So what's up today? I've been dealing with stuff that is, I try to make some resume. Sometimes it's hard. Sometimes it takes a lot of time because it have to do with some problems back that I want to elaborate on. And in this case, I wanted to do this resume of a portrayal of how things have been dealt with in the official community here. So that is part of my agenda today. Maybe I go to the highest court here. Not court. Who am I? I don't believe in courts, because the truth will be altered. It will be the court today is corrupt, so it's not for simple people like me. I'm not a court man. I don't want to pursue cases against people, and exactly for that I got some reward out of what have happened maybe five years ago, close to five. 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. It's more or less five years past the line. And when you are waiting, you don't know exactly what to do, but maybe to wait is the thing you can do. Sometimes that needs a lot of patience. So while I'm not doing anything, I can do something. And this have been, these videos have been something which I more and more grow some skills out of, because it's needed to enhance my language abilities. My teacher back then had some remarks on my language skills, my pronunciation, my grammar, and all these guys. Grammar was a foreign language to me. What is grammar, my friend? Grammar is something that you talk in past tense and in futuristic. I believe in time, and obviously the language is very dependent on time. I have gone many days now wishing to talk about either it's the time that is moving or the space. So I don't know how to start that. It's quite hard, but when always in a language realm, the realm of language which contains the whole life, it's always very specifically important, and I'm not good in that, keeping that, because I go back as it's now and talk about what happened back then. So those that doesn't know that trick of mine, he or she would be lost, because either it's happening now or it happened before or it will happen in the future. But all the grammar is all about which time, point in time. Sometimes that to wait for the time is, it takes patience. I may have talked about patience before, but not in length. It's because that it's hard to get at, to get to talk about time, and get to talk about patience when time is running. It's the polar opposite of what we supposed to do. If you are listening to this, you may have experienced some tense strain or some drive, because you want to dispute the argument of not doing anything. You want to, because every nerve in our body, in our psyche, is that we are moving forward in time. We are connected to time, which is moving forward. But I don't wholeheartedly believe that is the fact. You see, not to be gross or graphic, but it's kind of true that when you stop moving, when you know that something is going to happen, then you stop doing anything. You stop. Don't go to sleep. That is cheating. And then the time will advance faster. But when you stop moving, it's you delay. The time goes much, much slower. But when you go in a fast, that makes me, when you move, when you are doing things, when you are running, when you are working, when you are doing all sorts of stuff, when you're talking, even when you are talking, moving your lips, that's when the time feels it's rushing away. You lose track of yourself or of time. So, my friends, if you see a carcass, it's a proof that time stopped there. That's when the time stopped. Not in fact, because the time is now. Even the carcass knows on some level that it's here, it's now. But it's as everything within this carcass stopped. So when you stop, when your body stop, something innate in you say, no, I'm alive. I'm alive. I have to move in a certain direction. I can't stop. I can't wait, because if I stop, if I just sit in my chair, my body will break down by itself. And it's true. If you stop moving, stop the agility of everything, so to say, it's true that your body, it will collapse in the end. It will collapse. And look at a carcass. Whatever carcass you will find, it will show that the lack of movement, the lack of activity will break it down. I see on many people's cases that they grow old and they stop moving. They stop moving, they stop doing something, they stop everything. So they need help. Everything is going in. That's the mouth is the only thing that is moving. That's how we can keep the body intact, because we are eating. We need intestines in order to work, and we keep the core of the of the body intact. But we have to go out. We have to work. We have to do something. And to be patient is kind of very polar opposite of what we are all about. You can't be patient when you know the time is running. So the idea of being patient and not doing anything about certain things is quite hard. It's more or less, I would say, it's impossible. So in case you need to stop doing something about certain stuff, you stop doing it. And you will increase other sides of you that is dormant, that is not active. So you will activate something that will promote everything. Like if you go blind, you activate, you have to accept your blindness. It's stop, the eyes have stopped moving, so to say, stopped training itself. The eyes need this kind of exercise of training. They say that if you used to look at the screen and the computer screen or cell phone screen and so on, the eyes will be damaged. So we need the training, even the stimulants of colors, distances and environment is very important for the eyes, because I don't know whether it's a retina or whatever it is different aspects of the eyes that needs activity. So when that goes down, that the eyes is collapsing, it will promote. You have to accept that this has happened. It's not because of you in every case. It's because that some sickness or something have touched the eyes, so you can't you can no longer see, you can no longer hear or whatever. You are blind, you are deaf, and you are whatever it is, you are handicapped. But to see that as a handicap is kind of a step back, because it's in life. When you have to stop doing something because if somebody makes you hurt, if someone do something wrong to you, unjust to you, you have to accept it. You can't fight back. To fight back is maybe the wrong move. In your case, it will be the wrong move. In my cases, it have been a wrong move if I'm fighting for something, some ideas, some rights. That is good. That is a good fight, and I wholeheartedly commit to that ideological fight that the activist always will keep in his heart. But when the fight turn to be a personal vendetta, personal fight with some persons, I can advise you to let that go. If the fight is against persons, if the fight is to be the best, biggest, most control, and whatever, that fight, that need to stop, because it's not going anywhere. It's tormenting other people. In fact, that is a tormenting of other people. If you put up a fight with other persons that want your harm, they want to harm you. Different reasons for that, but it can be that you ought to stop. That is not a way to go. In my case, that has been kind of obvious to me that if they are after you personally, you should stop. Don't go there. Rather ask for forgiveness if they can say to you, you did that, this and that, even if you didn't do it. Ask just for forgiveness, because that is a fight you shouldn't even win. In my case, I shouldn't win those cases that I was wrongly accused for something. They may accuse me. It's okay. I don't mind that. You can avoid court. You can avoid the jail. You can avoid prison, because all this personal vendetta stuff. So if you just leave it, it's personal. It's they took it. They left you in the pit. It should be okay. So on some level, it should be okay. I don't want to justify everything. No, it's not that I'm promoting that you are a prey for some animals. No, but in some, I don't want to talk more about it, because it's just a point. It's just a point in all this what I'm going to say. That a personal fight is not wanted, and should just leave it like that. And when that happens, when you have to realize that this is not a fight for me, this is not my fight, this is too personal, it's not my fight, just leave it. You have to leave it. And even though the fight for the idea, fight for the right reason, you have also to let go. In my case, I had to let it go, because it was it became very personal. People attacked me personally, and that stopped the whole fight. And when you do that, you can search, you can stop. It's not logical at all. I don't want to defend it as something is supernatural. You should stop it. I think you have to realize yourself that it comes to a certain point that you need to stop it. You can do other things, and it's such an exercise of that. When you stop, when you admit it's not my fight, you can concentrate, you can enhance different aspects of yourself. And these videos and some other things that I feel I needed to do, I did. I can do it. I proved to myself that I could do it, and I may continue. I think that the words out, more people should talk out of their personal experience, because it's missing out in very many degrees. That I don't want to expose myself like that. That is not the point. But speak out of personal experience, personal. Kind of when you admit, then when you come to a point where you admit that what you thought was wrong to do, you have to do it. And that is when that is a mature, I can say it because I know it, that is a mature decision, and it will help you to enhance, as if I am blind, I will enhance a way to reach to those parts of what I need to do in order to replace the sight ability. I have to work out within my own tools, as they say, work out within my own attributes. If you don't know what attributes is that you have qualities, innate qualities that you can enhance because you no longer have a limb or something, then you achieve certain abilities that you, the limb is not a handicap, it's maybe an attribute in itself that you didn't have this limb, so that you can do things in a different way that makes people mind blow. That's achievement. And many people that have been crippled, handicapped, and different, also emotionally or personally sides, they lost something. They had to stop. And that is when they say that this is no longer a handicap. This is just benefit. This is benefiting me. It benefits everybody. And when we look at some people that obviously have achieved that level of capabilities of doing things despite their limbs or whatever it is, we admire, we think highly of them, and that's good. That's how it is. In some regards, it's very, very admiring that people have done that. So when you see the time stops, or when you see a carcass in its own tomb, it have no movement. It have movement. On a certain level, it have movement. And therefore, they say that the soul is still in this, some parts of the soul is within this carcass that have not yet left. So I think you see that this time has stopped, or the reality, the space has stopped. So I'm wondering about what is really happening when we suffer and die. What is stopping? Is it the space that stops? Because we can still see it. We can still see the carcass. Even the time has stopped for the carcass. The time is... Or is it the space? The space has stopped. So is it very uncommon to think that in that realm of death, it's a certain space, different space altogether, because it's obviously a different space, because the time still exists. It's broadening up. You can be within time when the space has stopped moving. So you are liberated. You are flying. So when you die, slowly by slowly you release from your body. The space is a open arena that you can go in and out wherever you want. Well, that is I just let it out there for you to reflect on. I have no clue. I have no clue, but it's mind, it comes to my mind that the time and space is something worth reflecting on. Time and space. We exist in time and space, and I don't really know what really is happening, because we experience time as moving. But obviously, it should be kind of obvious that the space is moving, the time is standing still. It's the time is now, exactly now. And if that is so, what happens to the carcass, that the body that ceased to exist? In it's alive, it's alive, but does it build different attributes? I think all about the world, the reality, is the building attributes. Replace the body with some different qualities. Who knows? All this is taken from the Bible. I know that, because we are thought so. But even the secularists, the atheists, and so on, they have to reflect what time really is, what is moving. We never know, we can't know. For real, we can't prove anything. We can't even prove our own existence. I at least, I can't do that. It's just within the psyche, everything, and the psyche, what is that? So the world outside is, we can see the matter, but we have no clue about that kind of existence. It depends very much on how we are made and defined. We are more defined than we can define anything else. We have to come to grips with what we are, who we are, in relation to what. So we are moving, the space is moving, but it's also always in a relation to something beyond the space. So my friends, this is the last minute, and I think that it's good to come to terms with some disabilities. When you have to stop, you need to differentiate. We need to explore what more can I do beside what I had to stop. Never stop constantly. That's death. That is stagnancy. But to stop, be patient, is increasing your ability so much that you wouldn't believe when you see 10 years back. So my friends, I wish you all the best, much blessing, and have a good day today. Wait.